नमस्ते एवरीवन, आई एम योर को होस्ट शावनी मैम। वेलकम टू योर फेवरेट लर्निंग चैनल। द टॉपिक फॉर टुडेज वीडियो इज कंडक्शन इन प्लांट्स एंड डिफरेंस बिटवीन जाइलम एंड फ्लोएम। सो डू यू नो व्हाट द टर्म कंडक्शन मींस? सो कंडक्शन इज एक्चुअली अ प्रोसेस इन प्लांट्स इन विच सब्सटेंसेस आर ट्रांसपोर्टेड फ्रॉम वन पार्ट ऑफ द प्लांट to another part. So this process of transportation of substances from one part to another in a plant is called conduction. Okay, so now we already know that plants are autotrophs, which means they can synthesize their own food, and they do that by the help of a process called photosynthesis. Now what happens during photosynthesis? During photosynthesis, plants synthesize their food in the form of glucose, which is a carbohydrate, by using the raw materials like water from the soil and carbon dioxide from the atmosphere. And this process takes place in the presence of sunlight and in the presence of the green pigment called chlorophyll, right? So now the water required for photosynthesis, how is it absorbed? It is absorbed by the roots from the soil, and this water then has to reach to different parts of the plants, like to the leaves, right? As leaves are the main site for photosynthesis, correct? Then similarly, when the food gets prepared in the leaves, they must reach all other parts of the plants, right, for proper growth of the plants. So there is a specialized system for conduction of water and food in plants. Okay, and this conduction system consists of two structures. One is xylem and the other structure is phloem. Okay, so let's see what is xylem at first. So xylem is a plant conduction, it is a part of the conduction system in plants. So this xylem extends from top of the plant till the bottom of the plant, okay? And the xylem helps in transportation or conduction of water and dissolved minerals from the roots to the aerial parts of the plant. Aerial parts of the plant means the part of the plant that is present above the surface of the soil. So from roots, the water and dissolved minerals are transported with the help of xylem to all other aerial parts of the plant. So this system of transport that takes place by the help of xylem is actually unidirectional. That is, there is only one way flow from the roots to the aerial parts of the plant. So the flow is unidirectional or one way. And here water and minerals are being transported. Okay, then the different elements that are present in xylem are tracheids, vessels, xylem parenchyma, and xylem fibers. And the xylem has no end walls between the cells. Here we can see there are no end walls between the cells, okay? And here the xylem wall is stiffened with lignin. Now let's talk about the phloem, okay? So phloem, what it does is it helps in food transport from leaves to different parts of the plant. Now, the transportation that takes place with the help of phloem is bidirectional or two-way transport. Here we can see it is bidirectional. And here, food along with water can be transported with the help of phloem. Okay? And in phloem, we can see there are end walls with perforations are present. That was absent in case of xylem. And this phloem consists of different elements like phloem tube elements, phloem fiber, phloem parenchyma, and companion cells. Okay? So now let's talk about the differences between xylem and phloem. So the first character that we will consider here is the materials the materials that are transported. Let's see what are the different materials that are being transported by xylem and phloem. So, xylem helps in the transportation of water and minerals, or we can say water and dissolved minerals are mainly transported by xylem, and hence xylem is also known as water conducting tissue in plants because it mainly helps in the transportation of water and dissolved minerals. Now phloem helps in the transportation of food. So phloem is also known as food conducting tissue because it mainly focuses or mainly helps in the transportation of food in plants. Then the next character that we would consider is direction of transport. Direction of transport in case of xylem and phloem. So in xylem, the direction is from the roots to the aerial parts. To the aerial parts of plant. Whereas in case of phloem, it is from the leaves to root. From the leaves to root and then to storage organs. So we can say that xylem, in case of xylem, transportation is one way or unidirectional. Only in one way the transportation is carried out. Whereas in case of phloem, the transportation is bidirectional or it is two-way transport. Then let's see the various elements of xylem and phloem. So xylem consists of various elements like tracheids, vessels. Okay, tracheids, there is vessels. We can call it vessels or xylem vessels. Xylem vessels, then xylem parenchyma and xylem fibers. Okay, so these are the different elements of xylem, whereas the different elements of phloem are the sieve tubes, then phloem fiber, then phloem parenchyma, and companion cells. So these are the different elements of phloem. So now let's quickly revise the things that we have discussed today. Okay, so we understood the term conduction. So conduction is actually a process of transportation of substances that takes place from one part of the plant to the other part of the plant. So here we know that photosynthesis occurs in the leaves, which are the main site of photosynthesis. From there, the food has to be transported to other different parts of the plant for their proper growth. And for the process of photosynthesis, the roots have to absorb water and minerals from the soil, and then it must be transported or conducted to other parts of the plants, like mainly to the leaves. So all these processes of conduction is helped or it is facilitated by xylem and phloem. So what is xylem? Xylem is a water conducting tissue. We can call it a water conducting tissue because it mainly helps in the transport of water and minerals. And the direction of transport in case of xylem is one way flow or unidirectional, where water and minerals are absorbed by the roots and then they are carried to the aerial parts of the leaves. And in case of xylem, there are no end walls between the cells, and here the xylem wall is stiffened with the help of lignin. Okay, so the transport through xylem is mostly upward, it's only upward and it's unidirectional. Then phloem is a food conducting tissue, we can say, because it mainly helps in the transportation of food. The transportation by phloem is a two-way flow or bidirectional. And in case of phloem, we can see there are end walls that have perforations. So then we talked about the differences between xylem and phloem. So the first character that we considered was the materials that are transported. So xylem mainly helps in the transport of water and dissolved minerals, and hence I said that xylem can also be called as a water conducting tissue. Whereas phloem mainly helps in the transportation of food in plants. So it can also be called as a food conducting tissue in plants. Then we saw the direction of transport. So in case of xylem, the direction of transport is from roots to the aerial parts of the plant. And this direction is unidirectional. That is, it only, the transportation only takes place in one way. Whereas in case of phloem, from the leaves, substances are transported to root and then to storage organs. Here the transportation is bidirectional or it's a two-way transport. Then we saw different elements of xylem and phloem. So the different elements of xylem are tracheids, xylem vessels, xylem parenchyma and xylem fibers. Whereas the different elements of phloem are sieve tubes, phloem fibers, phloem parenchyma and companion cells. So I hope you all would have got some great insights by watching today's video. Please do not forget to like and share the video. Till then, thank you for watching.